Okay, this is taking a little too long.
I woke up in a bad dream. My head felt two sizes too small for my brain.
Max Payne, I envy your name.
And the killer was smiling.
Pleased to meet you. I'm Frankie the Bat Niagara.
Niagara, as in you cry a lot? He had a baseball bat and I was tied to a chair. Pissing him off was the smart thing to do.
Nothing wrong with a little laugh now and then. Take me, for example. I love to watch cartoons. Cartoon violence is a fascinating thing. Let's take a break. I need to take a leak and maybe grab a cold one at the bar. Don't worry. I'll be back to finish this off. And then, it's checkout time.
You play, you pay, you bastard. He swaggered out, and the door clanged shut behind him, locks clicking into place. Everyone makes mistakes. Mine hadn't been to crack jokes about the goon with the bat. He'd have cracked my skull regardless. It hadn't even been to trust a girl with a gun. I had blindly gone after the first bad guy on my hit list when I should have been aiming further up the ladder, at the head of the Punchinello family. I couldn't bring myself to be pissed at Mona. Guess I had a soft spot for a big face. But when somebody decides to play baseball with your head, you tend to get sore. They had dragged me back to the basement of Lupino's hotel. I was beaten, bruised, and blue. I felt like the chair I had broken to get free.
I hate this level.
All I had was Niagara's bat, sticky with my own blood. Without a gun, I'd be no match for Frankie's men. I'd have to play hide and seek with them.
That's embarrassing. Oh, I knew I was dead. This stupid fucking TMT mother. Jump on it. Jump on it. Stupid sucker. I could have been the one to die. But I did it. Freaking New York accent. Oh my god, I did an impersonation of that one actor.
Niagara's bat, sticky with my own blood. Without a gun, I'd be no match for Frankie's men. I'd have to play hide and seek with them.
That's embarrassing. God almighty, this is why I hate this one. Can't really be silent because, you know, there's two guys around you, and, you know, as soon as those guys turn the corner, there's gonna be guys turning the corner behind you and see you, so it's kind of a sucky hucky. You know, even though I want to do this as an October thing, it seems weird because it's a snowy game. But I guess because of the whole Valkyrie thing, how people
all
are in this game, and the nightmares, it makes me want to do this as an October thing.
Without a gun, I'd be no match for Frankie's men. I'd have to play hide and seek with them.
I really hate, though, how the freaking bat disappears.
We'll take care of it.
I know. So, what am I up to?
What the hell?
Really? I was that close and it didn't even hurt anyone. Well, it hurt someone, but it didn't even kill anyone? Really? God, I hate this. I hate this part. Every time I play this game, every time I see myself in the chair, I'm like, oh my god, I know this part and I dread this part so much.
All I had was Niagara's bat, sticky with my own blood. Without a gun, I'd be no match for Frankie's men. I'd have to play hide and seek with them.
It's Frankie's turn. We'll take care of it.
I know. So I wouldn't mind having a go at it myself.
It's Frankie's turn.
Yeah, I know.
Time here, so I will take your weapons. Thank you.
The newspaper caption for a murder scene. Baseball bat boy strip next to a sewer passage filled with bodies.
You'd better not mess with Captain Baseball Bat Boy. Even my arch enemy, Bicycle Helmet Girl, swoons at the sight of me. Aha!
There were enough corpses to put a mass murderer to shame.
That is the stupidest comic I've ever even read. And that is also the stupidest title I've ever heard of. Captain Baseball Bat Boy? Seriously, who would name a character that long?